guys. Hi, everyone. I wanted to jump on and check in with you guys because I know it's been a while, so I wanted to say hi to everyone. Hi. Hi, Nikki. I'm just sitting here listening to some music. I wanted to check in with you guys. It's been a little while, and thanks. I just literally I haven't even washed it, but thanks for liking my hair. I wanted to check in with you because since I last saw you, I got married, which has just been so amazing and was such a crazy experience. And me and Dee have been together for 9 years, so it's about time. But yeah, just so happy, and we had an amazing experience. I got married in Italy, which I just love Italy anyway, but I've just fallen more in love with it. Hey Dom! just fallen more in love with Italy, the country, the people, the food. I feel like a piece of pasta right now. I look like a piece of pasta because that's literally, can you hear me actually? Yeah. Literally all I've been eating is pasta, pizza, pasta, basically, for the past 2 months. So yeah. Shout out to Max. Hey. So I'm a piece of pasta, but I'm a happy piece of pasta because I'm a married piece of pasta. Oh, hi, Eleonora from Rome, Italy. We actually went to Rome as part of our little kind of honeymoon. Calling it a mini moon, because we did like a little trip after we got married. We did a little trip around Italy. We went to Rome and we went to Priano. It was just so beautiful. And then we went to Venice, which was amazing. I wanted to check in with you guys because also tonight I am going to be on NBC Songland, and I wanted to let you guys know because I'm really excited about it. Yay! It was really interesting. It was such a cool experience doing the show, because obviously I was working with up and coming songwriters, and it just reminded me of how I started out and how I, you know, was on a show where I was fighting for my dreams, and these songwriters were doing the same. So it really gave me a chance to support up and coming songwriters, support up and coming talent. And it was fun because doing the show, I didn't necessarily, basically the premise of the show is that there are songwriters that come and they submit their songs. We take the songs, we work on the songs, and then the artist records the song that they think that they want to record out of all of these songwriters' submissions. And I got the chance to pick something that's very different for me, that's kind of like different out of the ordinary of what I usually do, which was really fun because this show gave me the opportunity to just try something new and not necessarily go for a song that is a classic kind of song that I would do, but more of like an opportunity to showcase different artists as well as showcase a different side of me. So yeah, it was really, really fun. Hi Michelle, and hers truly, thank you. It's my feather tattoo, and I got this in honor of my grandmother. So every time I look in the mirror, I see it and I think of her. She's like always on my shoulder, which is nice. I'm very excited about seeing it. If you guys know, you know that I'm a horror fan, big time. So I'm going to see it next week. I'm so excited, such a horror fan. Saw you twice live in Birmingham. Oh, thank you. I love going to Birmingham. You guys are crazy and amazing. Always just so much love when I perform there. I love it. I'm just reading some of your comments. Oh, thank you guys, you're so sweet. Someone's like, I hate horror movies. Sorry. Because I love them. This was actually, the Songland song was a really good opportunity for me to kind of give you guys something for the summer, like a summer feel while I'm working on new music. And of course, as always, just thank you guys so much for always supporting me and for, you know, waiting patiently, because I want to give you something amazing and special. And every time I put something out of my own music, it's always something that I've worked really hard on, something that comes from the heart and that I feel is deserving of you guys. So that's why I do take time during my creative process and making music and songwriting. I take time to make sure that it's the right thing for me, and obviously that you guys are going to love as well, because that which comes from the heart easily reaches the heart. That's a quote that I always have in my mind whenever I'm doing music. It has to come from the heart. It has to come from a very genuine place, and it has to be right, which is why I've taken my time. But I'm very excited about new projects this year and next year. So I'm really hoping that I'm going to be getting some music out to you. Well, I will be getting some music out to you end of the year and next year. So I'm really excited about that. And I always appreciate how much you guys support me and send me so much love. And it's just after, you know, you guys have been rolling with me since day one, over 10 years ago. I actually love this song. Been practicing my Normani dance moves. Not as great as hers, but one day maybe. Yes, I love the Callum Scott duet. Like, that was, again, like something that really came from my heart and that I really put a lot of love and thought into. And yeah, it's one of my favourite duets that I've done. So, and I love Callum, my little buddy. But yeah, really excited to bring you guys new music. Excited for you guys to hear the new song that's going to be out today, which is fun. And it's going to be very different. So I'm looking forward to you guys hearing it. And again, like, it's a summer feel, something for you guys to just have for the summer while I'm working on new music. So that's exciting. Just looking at some of your comments. I see you. I see you too. I see you. but yeah, let me know what you guys think of the song, actually. And I want to see videos of you guys singing it and jamming along to it. So make sure you send me when you hear it. But I'm really excited. So make sure you tune in to NBC tonight. For everyone in the US, but then you can watch it everywhere from tomorrow. So all of my people at home in the UK can watch it from tomorrow. You can go online and see it. So I'm excited for you guys to watch it. Yeah, and I'll talk about it more after you see it, because I don't want to ruin the surprise of kind of what happens and what goes down. And also, make sure you guys come down to Hopefield Animal Sanctuary in the UK, Essex, whoever's in London or in Essex, or in the UK in general, wherever you are. Come down to Hopefield Animal Sanctuary in Brentwood in Essex. It's open, I think we're open every day of the week during the summer holidays. And then Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, when it's not summer holidays. So make sure you come down to Hopefield, see all our animals, our amazing rescue animals. We just had a bunch of new little baby bunnies that were born from some of our rescue bunnies. So make sure you go and see them because they're so, 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 so cute. Come down and support us because we always need lots of help, volunteers, or just come down and visit. Bring your kids, sisters, friends, nephews, everyone. Bring everyone down and come and support the animal sanctuary because the animals need you. Thank you. New song tonight. I'm working on new music. Oh, Jonathan, are you opening a store or a business? I am actually in the middle of opening a new project that's been a labour of love. Something that I've been thinking about doing for a good few years, and I'm actually building it right now. So I don't want to say what it is right now until it's finished, but it's going to be finished probably in the next month or so. So I'm really excited. It's a new business, so you know, support your local female businesswoman. But yeah, something again that I'm really excited about and that I've just been working on the sidelines. Because you know, as a woman, we can do multiple things and be successful at multiple things as well. So we've got to support each other and empower each other to broaden our horizons and to do things that we're passionate about and that we love. I hope to have a concert in Spain at some point. I mean, I'm really, really hopeful that I'm going to get to... I want a tour next year. That's like something that I really, really want to do in some capacity. So I'm working towards doing a tour next year. So I hope that you guys will all be there when I do. Next UK gig. Soon, very soon. Oh, who? Hi, Josie. Hi. Come to Washington. I did a show in Washington a few years ago that I really enjoyed. It was really fun. Yeah, I hope I had, again, like, my ideal scenario would be to tour next year. That would be a dream, to tour next year. So I'm going to definitely be working towards that. And doing that because that's something I really, really, really dream of doing next year. But I love you guys. I love you guys too. Make sure you... Hi from Shanghai. I just love how international everyone is on here. Like, everyone from all over the world. And like I said, I really appreciate you guys. Always appreciate you guys supporting me, listening to my music, checking in with me and what I'm doing. I am working hard to bring you new music and new projects that I'm really excited about. Also, my show that I filmed, The Oath, check me out. My character's name is Amber and it's already streaming in the UK. Already streaming in the US, and it started to stream in the UK on MyFive, so Channel 5, you can stream it on there, which is really exciting because it's a project that I was just so excited to be a part of. Very different. It's like an adrenaline rush, so you have to watch it, you have to check it out. I play a character called Amber, and it was really, really just such an interesting experience to play somebody like her and to really get into her character and dig deep into who she is. I don't know if you guys know, but I went to theatre school from a very young age, and I always really loved acting, but I never thought that I would be the kind of person that would be an actor, because I thought you had to be some kind of crazy extrovert and... But you don't. And I've been taking classes again for the past 5 years, public classes for the past 5 years, which has been really interesting and a different experience for me, because you know, although it's kind of, you use the same kind of tools as you do in music, you're just emoting, It is very different, and it's been really great doing class and being dedicated to something like that again, and being a student. I just think it's always important to be a student. Like I did a live stream a little while ago, and I was at a vocal retreat, and being a student again, just being a student of music, being a student of voice, and we can always keep learning and keep adding to our craft. So the acting has been really, really fulfilling for me, and I just really enjoy it. It's something I'm really dedicated to and passionate about, and yeah, something that I love doing, and that I'm glad that I get the opportunity to do it and to showcase a little bit of it to you. So make sure you stream The Oath on Channel 5, My 5, and you can also stream it, US can stream it on Crackle, Sony Crackle. So go and stream it and watch it. My necklace, Jan said, what does my necklace says Melrose. Melrose was my little rabbit that I had for a very long time, years and years and years, and she passed away a couple of years ago. So, oh, my phone just went off. Yeah, I got this little necklace made with my bunny's name on it, who passed away. It's in her memory. I haven't been to Turkey before. I heard it's beautiful. I love you guys. You guys are so sweet. Yes, Dee Ebora Melrose is the one that I rescued. She was just a street rabbit on the street with a guy, a homeless man, and I went up to him and I offered to like buy him some food, and he had a baby rabbit. Don't ask me why, just sitting on his bag. So I said I'd take her to a shelter. Then when I took her to the shelter, basically they couldn't take her in, so I ended up keeping her, and I'd never had a rabbit before, so I just treated her like a dog, and she just like ran around the house, and she's basically, everyone calls her a dog rabbit, called her a dog rabbit because she acted like a little dog. From the Philippines, hi from the Philippines, I love you guys. You are the reason too. make sure you check out NBC Tonight, Songland, or tomorrow if you want to watch it. I'm excited too, Ricardo, for Songland. You can watch it tomorrow as well. Again, it's all about supporting up-and-coming songwriters, which is a big reason why I did it. You know, I went on a show like that, and I had a big platform, and this show was giving songwriters a platform, and it's so important to the craft of music. Songwriters are so important, and a lot of the time are very underrated in the creations and in the creative process. So I'm glad that we're shining a light on songwriters, because these are the guys that we sit in the studio with and we craft our songs with, so it's important that they get to shine as well. So, hey, Melrose in Scotland. I didn't know there was Melrose in Scotland. That's cool. Hi, Brazil. Hi, guys. what's my favorite song that I've written? I wrote a song called Thank You with Toby Gad, and I wrote that for my mum and dad. And that's probably one of my favourite songs. I also wrote a song with Walter A called Here I Am, which is on my first album, Spirit. And that song is probably one of my favourite songs that I've written as well. And Happy, which I wrote with Brian Tedder, one of my favourite songs. So three. Three favourite songs. And I actually got to work again with Brian Tedder on the show, on Songland, which was really, really cool. You guys know we go so far back, and it was just cool to get to work with him on the show as well and see him shining on the show. It was really cool. Hi, England. I mean, I love Nicki Minaj, so yeah, definitely. Oh, a surprise cover version. When's the album coming? I'm working on it. Working on it. Oh, Philippines. Love you guys. Really love you guys. Ciao. Ciao from to Italy. And Hong Kong, that's so cool. I love just seeing like where everyone's tuning in from. It's so cool. So cool. Cambry, Ben. Yes, I love Tori Kelly. Her voice is so beautiful. She's such a good songwriter as well. Great artist. Hey, Leona, I love you. We need more music. I know, it's coming. Music is coming. It just takes a while. Like I said, I want to give you guys something that, you know, really is so special and so deserving of you. So again, thank you for always supporting me in my creative process and the time that it takes to make something that is truly meaningful, special, and deserving of you guys as well. So yeah, I'm working on it. And also I have some other projects that are coming too, so you guys will definitely have more from me this year and next year. Hi from Indonesia, love it. How is it to perform with Taylor Swift? Really fun. She's such a cool girl, woman. She's just such a great artist, so lovely to work with. And actually, Lover is one of my favorite songs of her right now. Actually, I think it's my favorite Taylor Swift song is Lover. It's so good. I've been singing it all week. Aw, hi Simone, thank you. Hi from the Netherlands, hi to the Netherlands. I just actually played Motivation by Nemani, because that song is sick. And that video is epic. Hi John Anthony, giving you a shout out. Yes, I actually worked with Ryan, and we have been working together on something special, so yeah. Any gigs in Germany? Hi to Malaysia. Hopefully, again, like I said, I'm really hoping to tour next year, so fingers crossed. My dream and plan is to tour next year and bring you guys some music. But I love you guys so much. Thank you for checking in with me and again for supporting me, and make sure that you check out Songland tonight on NBC. It's going to be different. It's going to be different. So I want you guys to see it. Let me know what you think, and make sure also you go and visit Hopefield if you're in England and the UK. Make sure you go and visit the animals there. I love you guys, and I'm going to check in with you very, very soon. Mwah, 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 mwah.